This Sandiaojiao is the most eastern part, and if you look at that rock outcrop there, that is actually physically the most eastern part.
这是芦苇宝屿，是不是？ 谢谢。
哇，很大！ Look at that, like a little lollipop. Let's see.
嗯。哦，冷啊！那个海胆有毒啦。
I'm here in Sandiaojiao, which is the most eastern part of the island of Taiwan. The English name means three minks, but in fact, there are no minks here. This is a translation of the name Santiago. When the Spanish came here in the early 1600s, they weren't sure where they came, and they named this area Santiago. After that, the Chinese translated that into Sandiaojiao. The famous fishing harbor is Magang Harbor, which is just down the road here, and it also has a very long and interesting history that we're going to explore a little bit later. For fishermen and commercial boats, the most important thing is navigation. And here in Sandiaojiao, we have the most eastern lighthouse in Taiwan. It was built in 1935 in response to two ships that sank both in 1929 and in 1931 off the coast here. And it is called the Eyes of Taiwan, Taiwan de Yanjing. It was destroyed in Second World War and rebuilt in 1946. And to this day is a guiding beacon for anyone who passes the eastern coast of Taiwan. In addition to the lighthouse behind me, you also have the radar here, which is used to give the planes that fly over Taiwan an indication of Taiwan's most easterly border. So if you come all the way to this most easterly point of Taiwan, Sandiaojiao, you should come up to where the lighthouse and the radar tower is. You also have a beautiful view of the Magang Harbor, and you can see the seashore from here. It's a fantastic view and definitely worth the excursion. I've come here to show you the most eastern part of Taiwan Island. This Sandiaojiao is the most eastern part, and if you look at that rock outcrop there, that is actually physically the most eastern part. This Sandiaojiao is the most northern part of the Snow Mountain Range. The Snow Mountain Range starts in the middle of Taiwan in Nantou and comes all the way up here to this most easterly part of Taiwan and goes from the high level lower and lower as it approaches the ocean, and here it falls into the ocean. And just below here, there are still mountains underneath the water, and that causes some currents and some unique turbulence that we'll explore in a few minutes. The water today is quite smooth, but you'll notice just off the coast here, a lot of white caps, a lot of rough water. And that's a specialty of this area, Sandiaojiao. Because the snowy mountains are coming into the ocean here in various steps, you have a strong current here. The tide in most places comes in 6-hour shifts, but here it comes in 8-hour and 4-hour shifts. And that's because the water here is kind of stuck in this area. And what you see out here, these waves, are a result of the strong currents that come through here and the fact that there are mountains underneath that push up the water. And that's a unique feature of this part. So when you take your boat across here, you may think it's very smooth, but all of a sudden you're gonna get into some very rough water here. Once you're past it, it's okay again. Just like Sandiaojiao is a transliteration of Santiago from the Spanish, this harbor also has been misnamed. It was originally called Magang. Mao refers to rabbit. And if you take your boat in here, you'll see two cliffs that kind of look like rabbit ears. And that's why the Chinese traditionally call this Magang. When the Japanese occupation came, they got that wrong and thought that it was Magang, which means horse harbor, and that's the name it has here. This harbor is a class 2 harbor. It doesn't have many boats anymore. It used to be a lot more populated, but it has a history of about 250 years, and the harbor itself, 200 years. So a very, very old traditional fishing village here. In the old days, even until 1979, there was no direct road from here to Taipei. You had to take the road to Fulong and take a train. So it's been quite isolated historically. Magang Harbor has a long history, and it used to have about 500 or 600 people living in it. But unfortunately, like is typical in many places in Taiwan, only a few hundred people or 100 people live here now. The harbor, however, has two very special products. The one of them is exactly the shihuadong. The other one is the baoyu, the abalone. Taiwan used to produce about 80% of the global farmed abalone. However, unfortunately, in 2003, due to some infection, the whole abalone industry collapsed here in Taiwan and they weren't growing any anymore. It's slowly starting to recover after many years, but in principle, it was really damaged by that. What I'd like to show you here is the difference between the Taiwanese abalone and the imported abalone. And we have the Li Sizhang, who is going to explain some of the aquaculture behind the abalone when we go inside here, and she'll talk to us about that. Li Sizhang, ni hao. Hi, ni hao. Li Sizhang, this is
the abalone, right? Yes, 你可以吃看看。好，我吃一颗，谢谢。这个拿起来哈，哇，很大。对，哇，
it just comes right out of the shell like that. Look at that, like a little lollipop. Let's see. It's excellent.
是不是很 Q 弹？Q
Q 的，非常好。这种的鲍鱼要多少时间可以那么大？诶，要一年以上的。
就是一年以上的，对，鲍鱼跟九孔又不一样哦。
对，这个我也是很了解。这个是算是鲍鱼，是不是？
对。
那这个是九孔，九孔。那差别是哪里看得出来？哦，九孔是我们台湾野生种。那像这一颗九孔的话，它是野生的，它不是养殖的。看它的后面，有绿绿的，
它是吃那个龙须菜，还有一些饲料。
那个鲍鱼，我看到它的最。
不一样的地方是，你是洞是掏出来的。对，鲍鱼它的孔是凸的，有没有？是不是很凸？九孔它也是有孔，可是它的孔比较小，比较平。但是九孔它不止九个孔，九是多的意思。那鲍鱼是哪里来的？从大陆那边引进苗，然后跟我们的九孔做交配。那味道有没有差别？
诶，九孔吃起来比较脆一点，那它的话是比较
Q。那我听说八十年代的那个鲍鱼在台湾养的非常的多，是不是？嘿，1970年的时候是九孔。
哦，是九孔。嘿，是九孔。
那这个鲍鱼的话是90年开始养。我听说大概2003年那些鲍鱼还有九孔开始有问题，是不是？
这原因是什么？
原因就是有一种病毒，到目前还是查不出来。那现在在马港还是很多人养鲍鱼跟猪孔嘛？哦，现在很少了，只剩下一两家，因为哈，当他们要长大的时候，没有那个海菜可以供应。
谢谢你今天的时间，我再吃一个可以吗？
可以。
好，谢谢。
这个你好意思再给人家再吃的，好东西哈。好，谢谢，真的好东西。那个
Q，
哇，赞了，一口应该太大了。还可以，因为就是好吃嘛，对不对？真的好吃，好吃哈。
One of the things you have to come and see if you come to Magang, Yugang are these old houses. This is another place where time has stood still. and the historical houses here are definitely worth seeing.
我们这边基本上就是石头屋。马刚看到现在的石头屋，大概都从150年到200出头左右。
为什么用石头做房子？
在别的地方哈、哦，可能会有土房子、竹房子。我们这边一定要100%石头屋，因为台风天海浪一大，除了石头屋以外，其余的房子都会倒塌。
对，
所以我们这边清一色一定都是石头屋，它相当相当的坚固。石头屋一般在砌的时候有一字砌，也叫平行砌，还有人字砌，还有叫做乱石砌。那我们现在这一座房子看到的整个面，这个就是人字砌，它是人字形的，
就斜斜的这个。
对对对，它是斜字形的，这样交叉交叉交叉，每一块石头的旁边会有6块石头，那这个就是所谓的一字砌啊，在这里嘛，平行，它一块一块的叠上去。那在房子的转弯的地方，它需要比较坚固，所以一定要这样子一字砌。
这个区还有多少个那个老房子？
我们现在马岗这个地区的房子大概有100多间，那其中大概有一半50-60间呢是石头屋。
This is an example of a house that has all three kinds of building methods. This style here is where they just kind of randomly place the rocks. That's the cheapest and easiest way. This way here on the corners, they have them lined up to provide that integral strength.And over here, they've gone with the diagonal method, although it's a little rough, but where they have the 6-stone configuration in the diagonal method. 这样的老师对不对？
对 ，very good.
好，谢谢你，谢谢 ，thank you. The more time I spend in these little fishing villages, the more I realize how special each one is. Each one has its own.Old architecture, its own old fishermen's stories, and its specialty foods. I hope that you can all take the time and visit these places and just spend a little time, walk through the streets, and I'm sure you'll find interesting things to see and even more interesting things to eat. And if you talk to some of the old people, you'll learn so much about Taiwan and you'll understand it so much better.So take a look at these. These abalones are huge. Teacher Wu found some that are actually half the size of his hand, if you look at his big hands. And that's what I'm gonna see if I can get. So hopefully I can get lucky on that.
找最大的石头欢，越大越好，一个人欢不动，两个人欢。那个海胆有毒啦，那个有毒，
我知道啊。I didn't find any abalone, but I found this beautiful sea urchin, and you can see he's alive and he's trying to escape. You need to be careful with these guys because they have poison. Too bad.